Right, this is fifth grade, module 3, lesson 11, where we're going to be subtracting fractions, only this time, instead of relying on our area model, we're going to be using that standard algorithm, and they call it making like units numerically. But basically, that means using that standard algorithm. All right, so this says, first find a common unit, then subtract. So the idea would be students can visualize, if they want, a couple of ways you as the teacher or you as the parent can help. You can ask the student to visualize what this would look like if we were to draw the area model. And we would know that, okay, this is a half, and then this one would be a fifth, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But then in order to get common denominators, the half would be cut into fifths, and the fifths would be cut into half. And now we can easily see that there are going to be 10 units. So we know that our common denominator is 10. Another way we could have found our common denominator is to write a list of twos. So 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and then of course that keeps going. And then do a list of fives, 5, 10, 15, 20, and we can stop right there because the fact that 10 shows up in both lists makes it a common denominator, a common unit. And so we know our common unit is going to be 10. So in order to get common units of 10, to turn a half into tenths, we have to multiply both the numerator and the denominator by 5. And to turn the fifth into tenths, we need to multiply both the numerator and the denominator by 2. So 1 half times 5 over 5 gives us 5 tenths. How do we do that? Well, that's because 1 times 5 is 5. 2 times 5 is 10. In a similar fashion, we've got 1 times 2 and 2 times and 5 times 2. So 1 times 2 is 2. And now we can subtract because we have common units or common denominator. So 5 tenths minus 2 tenths is equal to 3 tenths. Now if a student asks, well, if we subtract the 5 and the 2, why don't we subtract the tenths? And you can say, well, another way to write that problem would be 5 tenths minus 2 tenths. And that's equal to 3 tenths. So you can say that the tenths right here in number form, or here in label form, is kind of like the units. It's the label. And so you don't subtract those. You only subtract the quantities. 5 tenths and 2 tenths equaling 3 tenths. So there's a couple of ways we could subtract this problem. I'm going to start with the traditional way. The most common way is, well, first let's find our common unit or our common denominator. And either students will come up with that common denominator by thinking about the area model for the two fractions here, or they might make a list, 7, 14, 21, 28, and then 3, 6, 9, 12, 15, 18, 21, and then of course that tells us that 21 is our common denominator. So there's a couple of ways that we can use to get our common denominator. So, and then the traditional way would be to, and I'm going to erase that because I don't want that there, okay, is we can say, okay, 5 and 6 sevenths, and we know we want, 5 with a 21 in the denominator and 3 with a 21 at the denominator. And so how do we change sevenths into 21ths or 21firsts? So we times by 3, which means we're going to times both the numerator and the denominator by 3, minus, and then how do we take 2/3? How do we turn the thirds into 21ths or 21firsts? Well, You're going to multiply by 7, multiply by 7. So we've got, let's see, 3 times 7 is 21, 2 times 7 is 14, and 7 times 3 is 21, so 6 times 3 is 18. So now we can subtract. We can subtract 5 minus 3 gives us 5. 5 minus 3 does not give us 5. 5 minus 3, gives us 2. 2, right there. And then 18 21sts minus 14 21sts gives us 4 21sts. So our answer is 2 and 4 21ths, or 21sts. Now there's other ways we could have solved this. Another way we could have solved this, and I'm going to scroll down 5 and 6 sevenths minus 3 and 2 thirds. Was that what it was? 3 and 2 thirds? Yeah. All right. So another way we could have we could have done this is we could have started by subtracting the whole numbers. So we could have subtracted and get 5 minus 3. So 5 minus 3 gives us 2. So we're going to have 2 and 6 sevenths minus 2 thirds. And now we could, if we wanted to, now we're going to get a common denominator. But here's a kind of a cool thing. Instead of getting a common denominator in here, now, let's do a little bit of sneakiness. Let's separate this to 2 plus 6 sevenths minus 2 thirds. Now, I think our fifth graders can do 2 minus 2 thirds. Because they would imagine two holes, taking away 2 thirds of one of those holes, is going to end up with 1 and 1 third plus 6 sevenths. And now, get our common denominator, still 21 from our previous example. And now, to turn thirds into 21sts, you're going to multiply by 7. So both the numerator and the denominator is multiplied by 7, giving us 7 in the numerator. And how do you turn sevenths into 21sts? You're going to multiply by 3, which means the numerator is going to get multiplied by 3. So 6 times 3 is 18. And then we can add those together. And we're going to get 1 and 25 21sts, which is equal to 2 and 4 21sts. All right, same answer, but a totally different way. Now, teachers and parents, if this is something that speaks to students, let them work on it. Let them do it that way. Because at this point, we're not worried about efficiency. We're worried about building number sense and making sure we're getting the right answer. We're not worried about, I know a faster way than that. Just let them develop an understanding of the mathematics that's going on. And eventually, efficiency will take over. And the last problem for this video, it says 4.5 yards of cloth are needed to make a woman's dress. 2 2/7 yards are needed to make a girl's dress. So we've got woman's dress and a girl's dress. How much more cloth is needed to make a woman's dress than a girl's dress? All right. So what I'm going to do, it doesn't say we have to, but I'm going to draw a tape diagram to show what's going on. So I've got a woman and a girl. And we're going to begin by making their tape diagrams identical. All right. If it doesn't look like they're identical, they're supposed to be. And now we're going to go back and we're going to read the question. So it says, 4.5 yards of cloth are needed to make a woman's dress. All right, so that tells us that this woman's dress is 4.5 yards of cloth. Then the next part says 2 2/7 yards of cloth are needed to make a girl's dress. So what that means is the girl's tape diagram is supposed to be much smaller, and this piece right here is 2 2/7. And so the question says, how much more cloth is needed to make a woman's dress than a girl's dress? So the question is asking, right here, how much is this piece right here? So we're going to use subtraction to get that. This is a classic example of a tape diagram that just begs for subtraction to be the solution technique. All right, so we see that our common denominator, our common unit, is going to be 14. So I'm going to do this in the very traditional way. So we know we need to rename each of these fractions, this fraction and this fraction, to have 14 as the denominator. So I can see that 2, to turn halves into 14ths, we need to cut them into 7 pieces. So that's going to be multiply by 7 and multiply by 7. So that means our numerator is going to be 7, because 1 times 7 is 7. In the same way, down here, to turn sevenths into 14ths, you need to multiply by 2, which means this gets multiplied, the numerator gets multiplied by 2. So 2 times 2 is 4. And now we're ready to subtract. So 4 minus 2 is 2. 7/14 minus 4/14 equals 3/14. And that's our answer. How much more cloth is needed to make a woman's dress? It's 2 3/14 yards. YRDS is what how I'm going to abbreviate it. And that is 5th grade Module 3, Lesson 11, where we are really using that standard algorithm to subtract fractions.